For thousands of years, boats have pretty much operated the same way. In 2010, the America's Cup boats started foiling, where they actually lift up out of the water on hydrofoils. Suddenly all of the physics, all of the yacht design, classical yacht design, no longer applies, and it breaks all of the paradigms we've known from past cups. These guys race for about 25 minutes and their heart rates are in the vicinity of 180, 190. All of the energy on the boat is generated by human power, except for a few instrument systems. So these guys are key to actually operating the boat.
I'm Craig McFarlane. I'm the Physical Performance Manager for Oracle Team USA. And we're in an amazing, unique location in the dockyards here, very old buildings. The piece which is integral to our warm-ups, it's called a ping pong table. A lot of money won and lost here, so this is where the warm-up starts and the guys will filter through here. With the training, we do a lot of cross-training, and boxing is one thing we integrate. If you're not careful now what punches to use or dodge, you'll get hit in the face, so that's a quick one. Hand-eye coordination, again, you'll get hit in the face. And then footwork, there's a bit of that on the boat, so you need to sort of move your feet pretty quickly. The guys do need to be strong these days, so we have a pretty well-equipped strength area. We've got lifting platforms, you know, decent row of dumbbells. They go up to 150 pounds, which is fairly heavy for sailors, to be fair. And there's a few guys who lift that. So you want your guys in your primary positions that power the boat to be heavier. And you sacrifice the weight in the back end, so the likes of the wing trimmer and the helm, they're going to be the lightest possible. You know, we always like the guys to hang from stuff, so I mean, grip's important on the boat. And so we have a functional rig. We'll mix up a lot of the conditioning, so we do twice a week swimming. Once we'll take the guys to the pool in the town, and then we'll do open water swimming at Horseshoe Bay. I mean, the features around Bermuda, it's just a big training playground for me, so I'm very fortunate to be able to use and have access to this. It's just fantastic. So the guys are very adept at swimming, especially open water swimming, which is a lot more challenging. So we try and mix that up with hill running and beach sprints and get them back in the water again. These machines here are training machines. Basically called grinders, you could say. So they're upper body ergs, and they mirror what we do on the boat. They're not specific and look like what they are on the boat, but they're pretty close to the movement. So we have bespoke crank handles and handles which are the same length as what we have on the boat as well. So this is where the work gets done on dry land on these things here. They've been beat about a bit. Second campaign, so Technogym done well for these to last. This tramp I got fabricated the last campaign, so it enables us to sort of you know, get a lot of specific work in at times, and you know, it depends what phase we're working on. So this is a couple of sessions, so it's pretty nasty in the middle phase there, but it's a bit of a good mix there. Most teams are working bloody hard, to be fair. You know, all the trainers are working the guys in the right way, so come the America's Cup, every team's going to be pretty fit and ready to go. So